ENT is short for ears, nose, and throat. We take care of all both adult and childhood disorders of the ear, nose, and throat. One of the things I like about the specialty is we get to provide both pediatric and adult care. Currently, we are offering a surgery here at Baptist LaGrange for ear tube insertion for childhood ear disease and tonsillectomy and adenoidectomy for recurrent tonsil infection or recurrent sore throat. Symptoms of acute ear infection include inconsolable crying or frequent nocturnal awakening, diminished appetite, fussiness, and of course, fever. All of these are signs that ear fluid may have turned into ear infection. Other risk factors for recurrent ear disease that might require tube insertion include RSV infection in the first 6 months, early onset of the first ear infection, perhaps even at 4 months of age, a child who is in group daycare, or a child who has suffered frequent upper respiratory illnesses. The benefit of tube insertion is to provide a small ventilation opening in the eardrum. This prevents the reaccumulation of fluid behind the eardrum, which both protects the child from infection and improves their hearing immediately. Tubes are designed to stay in place anywhere from 12 to 15 months. Once the tube is out, most children have outgrown their ear problems.